Good morning, dear brothers and sisters of Good Neighbor Christian Fellowship, even to our relatives, friends, and classmates, both here and in other countries of the world. Today is the first Sunday of November, November 7, and we are happy again that the Lord has given us this opportunity that we can continue to offer our praise and our worship to Him in the name of Jesus Christ. In this light, I would like again to invite you, join me in a word of prayer. Shall we all bow our heads, close our eyes, and let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you today, November 7, that we can again, Lord, have the privilege to worship you and to praise you, to express our gratefulness, our thanksgiving to all the blessings that you are giving to us. Despite our unfaithfulness, Lord, you continue to be faithful to us. And I pray, Lord, that may you forgive us for all the sins that we commit against your will, against your words, that do not please you, that do not give glory to your name. And this morning, Lord, as we gather in our homes, may the Holy Spirit continue to be with us, to inspire us, to encourage us, to give us grace, mercy, and peace during this time of many challenges in our lives. And as we go to our new topic for the month of November, I pray that you continue to also to bless Pastor Rigo in his preparation and in his delivery of the messages that you want us to learn, that you want us to hear, that you want us to derive inspiration and encouragement. Lord, we pray that may you also make your power eminent, your being our Jehovah Rapha to our brothers and sisters and friends who are sick, who are receiving medical attention, who are taking medicines, Lord, that you will heal them, that you will touch them with your hands, that you will comfort them, that you will assure them that in your time, according to your purpose and your power, they will receive healing from you. Lord, we believe that as you save, you also heal and you provide. Because not only you are our Jehovah Rapha, you are our Jehovah Jireh. You provide for the needs of your children, especially those who are experiencing financial difficulty during this time of pandemic. Lord, I pray that may you always find us trusting you, believing in you, serving you, following you. And may our worship Sunday today be a source of joy and encouragement to all of us. This is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Ngayon po ay unang linggo, kagaya po ng aking sinabi, so we will be having our communion. I know that you are always ready with your juice, bread, or biscuit, because after the message of Pastor Rigo, he will lead us in our commemoration of what Jesus Christ told his disciple, that we will always remember your love, your sacrifice for the sins of the world by holding this communion. And we are happy that once a month, every first Sunday, even during this period of pandemic, we can, Lord, do this, Lord, to remember your kindness and your love for us. So after the message of Pastor Rigo, all of us will join in the communion. Also, today is this Sunday is our pledge month, our tithe month, and I know that you are all ready with your checks or with your cash to be given to the church, as the church continue also to do its social ministry in reaching out to the deserving members and friends of our church. Our topic for the month, as I have said last Sunday, is inspiring miracles of Christ. You know, during this time of many crises, many challenges, we have to remind ourselves, we have to assure ourselves that God, who did miracles before, is still doing miracles today and in the future. And this is best exemplified by what Jesus Christ did when he was here on earth. He was not just preaching the word. He was not just teaching the word. He was healing the sick. He was meeting the physical needs of people during his time. He did miracles not only to demonstrate the power of God, but to demonstrate the love and the compassion of God. Kaya po, ang amin pong layunin at ang aming pag-asa, Pastor Ribo, sa pagtalakay natin ng mga himala na ginawa ni Kristo ay magbigay sa atin ng hindi lamang po ng lakas ng loob, kundi ng lakas ng pananampalataya na hindi lingid sa Diyos ang kalagayan ng mga tao sa kasalukuyang panahon. Ang kailangan natin ay patuloy na manampalataya sa Kanya. At ang ating pong key verses ay nasa Matthew. Ito po ay mababasa natin sa Matthew chapter 9, verses 35 to 36. Jesus Christ, while he was teaching and preaching the word, he had compassion on the people. And that made him able to do these miracles. And Pastor Ribo will be selecting appropriate miracles that we will learn for the next 4 Sundays of the month of November. Before I end, yung pong ating mga kapatiran na nag-birthday, nagdiwang ng kanilang mga wedding anniversaries, nandiyan po sa screen ang kanilang mga pangalan, at tayo ay patuloy na bumabati sa kanila at naniniwala tayo na patuloy din nilang na tatanggap ang kagandahan loob sa kanila. So sa inyo lahat, happy birthday, happy wedding anniversary. Nariyan din po sa screen ang ating weekly ministry activities. Nawa ay maka-inspire sa inyo ito na one of these activities ay inyong madaluhan at magiging pakinabang hindi lamang po sa inyo, kundi sa lahat ng kasalukuyang dumadalo sa ating mga ministry weekly activities. Before I end, I would like to take this time na batiin special greetings sa kay Chapite. Si Chapite po sa both sa Dumlao and Santos clan ay siya na po yata yung oldest living member of our clan. So, Chapite, you celebrated your 90th birthday. Happy birthday and more blessings sa iyo. So, nawa ang ating pananabahan ngayong umaga ay maging kapakinabangan sa ating lahat at kapurihan sa ating Diyos. Amen at amen.